A historic win for gay rights in India. The Supreme Court just struck down a law that made homosexuality a crime. No more, though. Our Nikhil Kumar joins us now from New Delhi with more. So, Nikhil, let's start with the reaction across India to the Supreme Court's decision.
Rosemary, the reaction has been ecstatic. Everyone is smiling at the court. There were people gathered outside the courtroom waiting since early in the morning. We only heard late last night that this morning is when the Supreme Court would bring this matter up for hearing and deliver the verdict. We've been waiting for it for many, many months now. The context here is that back in 2009, a lower court actually said that this provision, Section 377, as it's known, this colonial era law, that it was unconstitutional. But then in 2013, a smaller bench of judges, two judges at the Supreme Court, they said that actually no, it is constitutional and that it's up to Parliament to strike it down. Ever since then, activists have been trying to bring it back to court to get other judges to hear it. That's exactly what happened. Last year, the court said that privacy is a fundamental right, and we knew then that on the basis of that ruling, this would come at some point soon. And it happened this morning. People were cheering. People are just so happy that they can finally be themselves. The law carried a potential penalty of life in prison. Now, you can imagine what that meant for millions, tens of millions of Indians who just couldn't be themselves. There was a law out there that said that they couldn't be themselves, and that if they were themselves, that if they embraced their identity, they could go to jail potentially for life. The signal from the country's highest court today is that no, it's okay to be yourself, and that nobody, the law cannot infringe upon your freedom, and that you can be whoever you want to be.
You know, it's hard to be celebratory when people do their jobs. And, you know, for Phil and for Ida, you know, they're down here in Lou's memory. And what he really wanted was to see this happen before he passed. And we weren't able to make that happen. But in his memory, we're going to be able to make it happen in the Senate. And for Ray Pfeiffer and for all the first responders and the victims and survivors that those names represent. We all know the name now of Jimmy Zadroga and Lou Alvarez and Ray Pfeiffer, but they represent a community of people that are in terrible pain and are sick and dying. You know, Phil brought up this point that 16 died this month. 16. What's happening to that community is urgent, it's dire, and it's heartbreaking. And so, look, these guys have put in the work for 15 years. John Feel has given 15 years of his life and half his foot and a kidney to this cause. And we just want them to be able to exhale. Passing this in the Senate in 2 weeks, and we're gonna hold Senator McConnell to his word, will be a chance to exhale, but it doesn't right. fix the grief and the suffering that they will continue to experience going forward. It just removes that extra burden that needn't have been there in the first place.